So, the last thing that I wanted to talk about is that all life forms on Earth pretty much undergo a similar process to this one in cell respiration. So, here you have a prokaryotic cell, an animal cell, and a plant cell. Now, the first thing I wanted to point out is that both animals and plant cells have mitochondria. So, plant cells also perform cell respiration, but some people think that plants get their energy out of photosynthesis. Well, that's true in a way that they make their sugar out of photosynthesis, but remember, only the leaves can do that. So all the other cells in a plant need to do cell respiration. And even the leaf cells themselves, when there's no sunlight, they need to do cell respiration. So that means that plants also breathe and do cell respiration in a similar way that we do. And they basically all have mitochondria to burn the sugar. The only difference is that as an organism, plant cells are capable of creating their own sugar, but only in the leaves. And even in the leaves, you're going to need cell respiration at some points to produce that energy. So they just store the energy for later, but as they get the energy out of the sugar through cell respiration, through mitochondria in the same way. Now, prokaryotes don't have mitochondria because they don't have internal membranes, and they're small enough to be almost the size of a mitochondria. So, like, mitochondria is big enough to be a prokaryote almost. So that means that you're not going to have all of this is not going to happen instead of mitochondria, which brings a good point. All of this process can happen without mitochondria. Which means you would get 38 ATPs of energy because you don't lose those 2 ATP that you consume during the grooming phase of the mitochondrial test. So while eukaryotes only make 36 ATP by the use of the mitochondria, prokaryotes actually make 38 ATP because they don't use them. But the problem is that they got to do the ETC at the cell membrane. They got to do this slowly and surely in a cytoplasm full of other chemical reactions, which distracts the process and everything gets more complicated and slow down. Mitochondria speed up the chemical reactions. So even though you lose 2 ATP, it's better to do it this way because it's going to be faster. So that's why the mitochondria is a good endosymbiont for eukaryotic cells. But the fact that all life forms on Earth do some sort of cell respiration, well, 99% of the life on Earth. There are some archaea bacteria that do different kind of processes. But the fact that most life on Earth does cell respiration of one kind or another indicates a relationship between all of this life on Earth, that perhaps all life on Earth came from the same life form which used this process as a good process. Now, while some life forms use electron acceptors other than oxygen and produce things other than water,
they all pretty much use a similar process, and this universality of the process speaks to the similarity between life forms and originality that of the evolutionary process of one life form leading to many. Also, remember, I had to speed up and talk very fast. This is all controlled through enzymes, and by deactivating enzymes, you can stop the processes and orient whether you go to fermentation or the Krebs cycle and so forth. So that is the final overview about this process, okay? And then if you want to get a review that tells you what you need to know, I will be recording a video about that as well, okay? So just basically a video that just lists what you need to know about cellular respiration in general, okay? Thanks.